Dark times have fallen upon the world. Sin has corrupted the people of this land. And in their despair, they have sought refuge in profane beliefs and wicked deeds. Crusades and pilgrimages to sacred territories have done little to abate the spread of such vices. A brave cleric has returned from one such crusade to our home village of Sinwell. This village has been stricken by the plague, the Black Death, born from the sins of its people. If Sinwell is to be pulled back from the precipice of hell, this pestilence must be purged. Whatever the price may be.
Lupo, you're still here. You got old, my friend. Oh. Are they not feeding you? Here, this is all that's left of my supper. It would seem the rumors are true then. Disease has found Sinwell. It's been a long journey back from the Holy Land. I longed eagerly for the day of my return, but this is not the home I once knew. I wonder if Master Ulrich is still here. Master Ulrich, it is good to see you again.
Cecil, you've arrived not a moment too soon.
Apologies, Master. The Holy Wars have left me worse for wear, and traveling no longer comes easily. How are you expecting me?
I received word your campaign has ended. I anticipated your return would soon follow. We are blessed to have you back, Cecile, after all this time. I sense change in your eyes. You have learned much in your time away.
I've learned to appreciate peace. I hoped to find it here, but word of the disease that plagues Sinwell reached me before I reached you.
By now you're well aware. It is not always in distant lands that our greatest enemies lurk. It is true, a grave malady afflicts Sinwell, and I fear more will be lost to it. But we will discuss further in the morning. I have arranged chambers for you. The night is dark, and you must rest. The people of Sinwell will need you. Though they may not yet know it. Rest well, and Cecile, I would ask you to focus on your duties. Don't waste time on that dog.
Seems to weigh heavy on Master Ulrich, but I feel something greater troubles him. Heavens, a proper bed. I swear, I haven't slept in anything but cold, hard ground in months.
Hmm.
face what comes, Seeker of Serenity. Do what you believe. Do what you must. Above all, question the path set before you. That was far stranger than my usual dreams. The sun is out. Master Ulrich will be waiting. I'd best not keep him.
I trust your rest was uninterrupted.
Mostly. My dreams have been unsettling of late.
Be on guard. Dreams have often revealed many marvels to me, but the messenger was not always divine.
Master Ulrich?
I wish we had the time to talk of your experiences in the Crusade, Cecil. There is much I would like to know of your journey in the Holy Lands. But we must act on this plague with haste.
Agreed. My stories can wait. What do you know of this plague?
The Black Death does not only affect Sinwell. Surrounding settlements have suffered too. We must bring an end to this affliction for the sake of our townsfolk. We must stop it from spreading further. You have seen much on your pilgrimage, Cecil. You have witnessed firsthand the evil that sin has brought upon the world. It is sin that has brought this plague upon this village. And it is only by purging sin that your home can be saved.
What would you have me do?
You must free our people from the seven deadly sins. It is the only way.
But how would I even begin doing that? Not all may be willing to render confession, or even desire to repent.
You are right. The sacrament of penance will not suffice. No, Sinwell is too far gone for the conventional ways to have any meaningful effect. Take this glass fragment. Repair the stained glass in our chapel window. I will explain why in due course.
Werewolf. Fearsome creature. I remember seeing this as a child, and recall it haunting several of my nightmares. Why would Master Ulrich need this repaired? I should return to him. The werewolf's icon graces our chapel once more, though I am not sure how this helps us.
Last night's festival revealed gluttony holds some of our people in a tight clutch. You saw plainly that Brom has imbibed far too much. I believe he depleted our last supply of the communion wine. You must set an example and defeat the demons within the sinner. You must enter his mind, Cecile. and cast out his sins.
Enter his mind? How is that possible?
There are sacred mysteries and sacraments, well beyond what even the wisest scholars are aware of. I will show you how to enter their minds. But beware. Anyone invading another's mind will appear as an hostile entity. The sinner's mind will see you only as a demon.
That is why you asked me to repair the stained glass window?
Precisely. In the villagers' minds, you will manifest as the monsters they see in our chapel stained glass. And they will fight back any way they can.
How did it come to this, Master Ulrich? This village was once a sanctuary for good, faithful people.
I grew complacent over the years, and all kinds of vices invited themselves here. We must excise these sins from our people, Cecil. The method may not be gentle, but it is necessary. Once you have cleansed the chapel grounds of all sinners, return to me.
I understand. I will do what I can.
Of your own immortal soul, faithful Cecil. Is it worth surrendering to save those that are already damned? Those that are less deserving than you? How did I get here? The entire ordeal felt like a nightmare. I'd believe it so, were it not for the strange fruit I found within Brom's mind. What is it? Perhaps Master Ulrich will know more, though my work is not done yet. Master Ulrich mentioned more drunken revelers around the chapel grounds. I remember when David was born, just a few weeks before I departed Sinwell. He's still but a boy. He couldn't understand what sin is to know when he is committing it.
Yes, David's soul is pure. You need not enter his mind. Yes, but if you do enter, you may find it will aid your future endeavors.
Is Glutwin's neglectful parenting more abhorrent than the Divine Father's disregard for his children? What dutiful father idly watches his creation suffer and does nothing to intervene?
I'm not sure I'll ever get used to this. No time to waste. I need to look for another sinner. There's someone in the confessional. It's been long since I last took confession. Perhaps it's time again.
Forgive me, Father, for I have sinned.
I set eyes on a sinner behind the bush in the chapel's courtyard, and I fear I judged him harshly.
It is not our place to judge, friend. I know. Still, how else will the sinner's soul be saved?
We will all be judged eventually, but not all will be saved. Repent, and I can absolve you of your...
He left?
At least I know where to find the last sinner now.
Thank you.
How long would you battle if you knew victory could never be achieved? Sin can never truly be eradicated. Humanity was born in sin, and to sin it shall return.
This constant to and fro between dreaming and waking, it's hard to know what is real. But I believe that's all the sinners I can find. I should see Master Ulrich.
What in heaven was that?
I prefer it when dreams only come to me in my sleep.
Master Ulrich, I found the sinners around the chapel. They are cleansed of sin.
Good. You have done well, Cecil. Did you find any artifacts in their minds?
Artifacts? I did. This fruit. They appear to be symbolic, but their purpose eludes me.
From the garden itself. They are the forbidden fruit from the tree of knowledge of good and evil.
It cannot be. How did they end up in the minds of sinners?
The first forbidden fruit was the means the devil used to tempt humanity. It only took a bite to birth original sin, leading to humanity's fall and expulsion from the garden. But there was more fruit on the tree of knowledge that mysteriously went missing. It was rumored the devil stole them for his own ends. Now we know Sinwell too has been led to temptation.
The devil himself has corrupted the people of Sinwell?
I think that is now a bygone conclusion. We must find the remaining forbidden fruit and destroy them. Only then can we stop the devil from driving Sinwell deeper into sin. But before we continue, Cecil, how are you faring?
I cannot say yet. I know my purpose, but I fear doubt has crawled into my thoughts.
It is more than understandable. You are exhausted. First, I believe you have recovered another glass fragment to restore an additional window. Do so, and then rest. There is much still to do.
Is it necessary I bring this horror into the minds of these sinners? Is there no other way to lead them to the light than to drown them in such darkness?
Why must demons adorn the windows of a quaint little chapel? Of all the beauty that lies in creation, between heaven and earth, why depict hell's abominations?
are more souls to save. I should best get to it. My eye caught some familiar faces idling by the marketplace. The festival may be long over, but honest work has yet to return.
Thank you.
Sloth is the most deceiving of sins, they say. What harm could lie in doing nothing? When you are damned if you act, damned if you don't, what avenue is left but certain damnation? does envy not have its uses? If we never sought the good others have, aren't we doomed to misery? Can a slave not gaze upon a free man and covet that freedom?
Thank you.
soul you save, the toll your actions take on your own soul grows heavier. And yet, sloth isn't merely an action. It is a sin that disguises itself within the easy route, the path of least resistance. Who would blame you for doing as you're told, rather than investigating the truth for yourself? His life. It would seem only those who sleep are incapable of sin.
That's all the sinners I've been able to track down. Master Ulrich will want the forbidden fruit I've collected. He seems to be taking confession. I shouldn't intrude.
Have patience. I have enough now, and more will come. I will honor our agreement. You know better than to challenge my word.
Master Ulrich left, but the confessional is still occupied.
A glass fragment. Who was Master Ulrich talking to? What did the stranger want? Master, I have seen a shadow, a strange man, creeping around the chapel.
We haven't the time for idle rumor or scaremongering, Cecil. Speak plainly.
Then I'll confess. Master, I saw you speaking with a stranger in the confessional.
None of import. Sinwell is a crossroads. Strangers come and go. Some are less courteous than others. Now, to the task at hand. Do you have the forbidden fruit?
I do.
Good. We must focus on what's important, Cecile. I believe you have more glass fragments. Another section of the chapel window needs repairing. Then I suggest you get more rest. More sinners will soon reveal themselves.
The mighty griffin, a noble beast, were it not for its appetite for the human liver. And now I must embody it.
Ere the time of the sea's parting, a man by the name of Ezra loved the father dearly. Challenging that faith, the devil claimed, Ezra is only faithful due to his happy life. Thus, the father allowed the devil to test Ezra's conviction. Ezra suffered greatly, losing his livestock, home, health, even his children. Though devastated, Ezra remained faithful to the father. And Ezra was rewarded for passing the devil's test, the father granting him back twice what he lost. But why did the father doubt Ezra's faith so? If the father knows all, was Ezra's suffering truly necessary?
Damned nightmares are losing me sleep. But I cannot deny there is a grain of fact in them. Has Master Ulrich been honest with me? I want to believe it so. Yet sometimes I wonder if he has been sparing with the truth. Is it right I assault the minds of these sinners with such demonic forms? Then again, the plague is a far greater evil than the demons I manifest in their minds. Yes, if I had another choice, I would take it in a heartbeat. But I don't.
Is greed not merely the struggle to strive for better? Would you survive the winter had you not hoarded crops over the summer? Would you have medicine had you not desired to prolong your life? Would you know faith had thirst for knowledge not spread it across the world?